फ्रेंड्स दिस इज फोर्थ टॉपिक फ्रॉम 12th साइंस फिजिक्स सेक्शन 1 फ्रॉम HSC बोर्ड. इट इज थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. सो इट इज हैविंग कंपल्सरी मार्क्स 5 एंड मार्क्स विथ ऑप्शन 7. ओके, सो वी विल स्टडी द टॉपिक इन डिटेल. ओके, सो वी नो दैट व्हेन वी ड्राइव अ व्हीकल, व्हेन वी ड्राइव अ कार, its engine gets heated. Okay, so we know it very well. Second one is when we exercise our body gets warmer. That means in both the cases work is done and heat is produced. Okay, so one more example is that when hot body is kept in cold surrounding, so we observe that hot body gets cooler and cold body gets warmer. So there is something which is transferred from body at higher temperature to body at lower temperature. So this something transferred is nothing but heat. Okay, so when hot body is kept in cold, in contact with cold object, so something is exchanged between them. So this something is nothing but heat. Okay, so thermodynamics is branch of physics that studies, that deals with heat, temperature, heat and its interconversion with other forms of energy. So these things we are going to study in thermodynamics. So in this topic we are going to study what is thermodynamic state, what is thermodynamic variables, what is thermodynamic process, laws of thermodynamics, applications of laws of thermodynamics, what is heat engine, Carnot cycle, efficiency of heat engines. These articles we are going to study in thermodynamics. Okay, now I will repeat the example again. When hot body is kept in contact with cold object, we know that heat is transferred from body at higher temperature to body at lower temperature. The process continues till both objects acquire same temperature. Okay, the heat transfer continues till both the bodies acquire same temperature. Okay, so that means thermal equilibrium is reached. At thermal equilibrium, the two objects are at same temperature. This condition is known as thermal equilibrium. That means as both the objects are at same temperature, there is no need to transfer heat. Okay, so this is thermal equilibrium. Next we are going to study is zeroth law of thermodynamics. Okay, zeroth law of thermodynamics. See here, we consider the three systems A, B and C. Okay, see here, system A is in contact or in thermal equilibrium with system B. We are having three systems. Okay, so firstly I will write system A is in contact in thermal equilibrium. System A is in thermal equilibrium with system B. So second thing is that system A is, so see here, system C, system B. Okay, first thing is that system A is in thermal equilibrium with system B. Second thing is that system A is in thermal equilibrium with system C. A is in equilibrium with B, A is in equilibrium with C. So this implies that system B and system C both are in thermal equilibrium. So see here, I will repeat again. If two systems are each in thermal equilibrium with third system, B and C are the two systems, they are in thermal equilibrium with A separately, then B and C are in thermal equilibrium. So this is nothing but zeroth law of thermodynamics. Okay. Next term that we need very frequently while studying thermodynamics is thermometry. So in thermometry, temperature measurement concept is there. So to measure temperature, different temperature scales are involved, such as Kelvin scale, then Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale, like that. So these temperature scales we have studied in 11th standard. Okay, so now we are going to use that. We are not going to explain this concept. Okay, one more term we are going to see is internal energy. So again we consider the example that a glass of water is kept on a table. We know that it is not moving. That means its kinetic energy is zero. Okay, so its potential energy may be also taken to be zero. But we know that glass of containing water, it consists of water molecules. We know that the molecules of water are always in state of random motion. So because of this random motion, that means they are moving here and there in all directions with all possible velocities. So it is nothing but random motion of molecules. So the object possesses the energy because of this random motion of molecules. So this is nothing but internal energy. It is denoted by letter U. So this is internal energy possessed by object due to random motion of molecules of object. Okay, so this is internal energy. Next term is, what is thermodynamic system? Okay, so consider a glass full of water, it is kept on a table. Suppose it is hot water. So it will radiate heat, it will emit heat. That means it will exchange heat with the this air, surrounding air. Okay, so we are considering this system. So thermodynamic system is group of object, collection of object that have ability to exchange energy with the surrounding. That means here this hot water can exchange heat with the surrounding. So this hot water filled with this glass filled with hot water can be taken as system. So this is thermodynamic system. This glass or vessel containing water is the boundary of this thermodynamic system. Okay, so the all other relevant part in the room are surrounding or environment of this related to this thermodynamic system. Okay, so this system can exchange heat with the surrounding. Surrounding can also be named as environment. So this is system. So this is nothing but boundary of the system. So this is boundary of the system. These objects can exchange heat with the environment. Okay, so accordingly, whether the system exchanges matter or it exchanges both or neither of the two, the systems can be classified as follows. Okay, first one is open system. So here if we consider a hot water or water boiling in a kettle or water boiling in a vessel, so it is open system. Here the system exchanges heat to the surrounding. So it exchanges steam also. Steam is nothing but matter. So heat as well as matter is exchanged by the system to the surrounding. So this is nothing but open system. Okay, we will consider next example, that is closed system. So here we consider example of water boiling in a boiler with closed wall. So this wall is closed. Okay, so it will emit heat, it will radiate heat to the surrounding, but it cannot escape steam into the air. It cannot escape steam into the surrounding. So this is closed system. Okay, next one is isolated system. So here we consider example of thermos flask. Okay, so in thermos flask, no heat is radiated out or no matter is also radiated out. It is emitted, no matter or heat is emitted into the surrounding, into the environment. So it is isolated system. It is completely sealed system. No heat or matter is exchanged with the surrounding. So this is open system, closed system and isolated system.